Hello, I am Kat Woods. Welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to share with you today what I am going to be doing for the 30 days. So for those of you who are watching it for this month, you know what month it is. I don't want to say a month just in case somebody's watching this months from now. All right, so you can start this whenever. Whether it's in the middle of the month, the beginning, the end, it does not matter. Just do it for 30 days, okay? So for the 30 days, I'm going to be focusing on prayer. I did do a video prior to this, so I will probably somehow, I'll put them in a little playlist. That's what I'll do. I'll put this 30-day prayer, that's what I'm going to call it, 30-day prayer challenge, something, I don't know, 30-day something. You're going to be able to tell in a playlist, so you'll be able to watch them. So if you're watching this months from now, whatever, you don't have to scroll through all of my videos and look for it. So this 30-day prayer challenge will be in a playlist, okay? So make sure you watch all of the videos. I will be doing quite a few of them just to keep you up to date what I'm doing. So maybe 2 weeks from now, I don't know how often I'm going to do it, or we'll have the time to update you. But if you're a part of the group, you will be seeing daily posts of what I am doing. I'm going to post the verses, maybe one, maybe two, maybe I don't know how many, however many verses I'm able to do. I'll post it just in case somebody does not have a Bible. I strongly encourage everyone to join me in this. Don't only put the burden on me to be sharing verses. I really expect everyone in my groups to do this. I will extend this study to also my sister group. So for those of you who are in my sister group, that group is more of a creative group. There, you can be as creative as you want. You can really dive deep into this, and you can grow your Bible gardens really fast with this 30-day challenge, okay? So for those of you who are starting them, who are is maybe brand new, and you've seen my Bible garden videos, and you're like, I would love to do this, but I don't know what to do and how to do it, this challenge will be perfect for you. However, if you're in my marking group, there we're not focused on the creative side. We're focused solely on the Bible study part. I've already shared my tips and tricks for you there. All right. I will not be doing any demonstration on creativity stuff right now. I have a ton of videos over how to be creative already done. There's a Bible Garden Playlist 101. So make sure you check that out for ideas. But right now I'm going to be showing you personally on what I'm going to be doing for the 30 days and giving you ideas on what you can do. All right. We do have our little producer. He is here. He has his work uniform on and he is ready to go. Let me show you just so. This is little Desari. So I'm sure you can hear him purring. All right. So that's who's here, our little producer. Okay. In my other video, I did share Bibles you can use, all right? These are an additional Bibles, and these Bibles are the ones I'm going to be focused on. I just picked them out last night, so I didn't know until last night. Typically, that's how it happens for me. I'm led to certain Bibles for certain reasons at different times, okay? So for the first one right here, again, these are tips you can do in any Bible. Bible study, Bible journaling, study Bible, wide margin Bible, mini Bible. It does not matter the type of Bible or translation. What I'm doing in mine, you can take it also into yours. You can expand on it. You can change it. Okay. Always, always stressing that on my channel. I'm not going to really share too much about this Bible. I know it's super, super adorable and cute. It's no longer available, so I'm not even going to talk about it. Okay. So, for those of you who know what this Bible is, you know what it is. All right. So what this one is, I have been working through this Bible. This is my transformation Bible. I've used this Bible to overcome fear, doubt, worry, all of those. So whenever I see any green scriptures marked up, I know it's going to pertain to fear, doubt, worry, anxiety, something like that. Okay? Now, for this particular next come through the Bible, I've already covered it from Genesis to Revelations. The next read through this Bible, I'm going to be using a different color. So now I'm going to have orange. Orange is going to be covering prayer. Anytime I see any orange verses like this highlighted, whether it's underlined, whether it's highlighted, I know that's a verse I can use for prayer, whether it's talking about prayer, whether it's a verse. I'll go further on through on what I mean by another example in this Bible, but right now just that I can use for prayer. Going through this, it really helped me learn something new about the Old Testament. Because there were these verses, I wonder if this is one I can use. And Joseph said unto his father, they are my sons whom God has given me in this place. And he said, bring them, I pray thee, unto me, and I will bless them. So something like that, it does have pray in it. Where did I get this verse from in particular? Because it's not something I can relate to at this very moment. I got it from my Strong's Concordance. So if you don't have a Strong's Concordance, I did mention in the other video, you can always Google, but I really recommend every student of the Word, we really need one of these. All right, so I just simply opened it up. I went to the very first prayed and it's right here. All right, I'm just going through the list and underlining them. So I couldn't really understand, especially in Genesis, any, like, there's a lot of Old Testament verses that I could relate to, but this one in particular, I'm like, I don't really understand it. I can't really relate to it. Let me see if I can find another one. Something like this we can better relate to right now. So it says, okay, I want to give a struggle. Okay, I want to give a struggle one. All right, so something that we cannot relate to. We're like, yeah, that's super old. He's asking, so Joseph said unto his father, they are my sons whom God has given me in this place. And he said, bring them and I will pray unto them and I will bless them. So what is this verse telling you right now in modern day, times, right? I was pondering, how can I make this verse work for me? And then it came to me, I don't have to pray this word for word. You know, none of us have to pray this word for word. We can switch it up. So what this is telling me to do, I need to be praying over my own children. I can ask God to guide them. I can ask God, hey, I'm bringing my boys to you. I'm bringing my children to you. I'm laying them up down at your feet. Please watch them, guide them, strengthen them, whatever they need right now. Or maybe I'm arguing with my children right now, and I can use this, hey, he's really being this way right now, and I want to yell at him, but no, Lord, let me have a heart of blessing towards him. So even though it's something we may not be able to relate to right now, really think about it. Switch it up. You don't obviously need it. Or when Abraham was told to, I'm not saying that there's any verses like that, but just say you were led to a verse that says you have to sacrifice your son. Obviously, we don't do things like that anymore. God would never, ever do that, but we know the story behind that. Sacrifice your son. So sacrifice, like change that word to something different. Pray that he is sacrificing strongholds on him. So let it be to where he's not pulled towards one direction in particular, and those chains are broken, and he's sacrificing them and bringing them onto God. You know, so that marking up all these verses, especially in Genesis, I think there was like one verse in Exodus that I really highlighted. It kind of, you were able to change the words up and write them out to where they fit more modern times, but Genesis is where I really struggled with these verses on pray. Now, when you go through the Strong's Concordance, you have pray, you have praying, you have prayed, like past tense, I've already prayed this. I haven't read or reached any of those verses yet. This is simply pray. That's all they're doing. They pray. I pray that Rebecca will come to the well, and I pray that these steps that he was asking God for, I can't relate to that first. How am I going to ask God to lead this woman to me? You know, stuff like that. I was super confused by it until he told me to think deeper. Go past just the simple black and white words that you are using. You can use it. You just have to think about it, meditate on it, and ponder how you can switch them up. We don't need these words word for word, especially if we're praying them. You can switch them up. A great example of doing that would be, I did it right here in my Caxton. So right here, Psalms, woo-wee. I can do this to the Psalms all the time. It's really, really, really simple to do, really easy to do. So if you're a beginner, I highly recommend just going through the Psalms. Again, if you don't have any tools, be a part of my group. I will be sharing verses every single day that you can use. Hopefully, everybody else will be doing the same. If I don't have anything sharing that you're able to use, go through the group and see if somebody else does. And if you think that one particular verse you can't use for whatever reason, go back again, look at it, ponder on it, and see if there's something hidden in there for you. All right? Just don't look at it for the plain black and white like I just shared you in that other Bible. All right? So this one right here, this is in the NLT. So already a simple, really easy to understand translation. But it says, be good to your servant, that I may live and obey your word. You can pray that as is. Super powerful, super easy, simple. Highlight it, pray, done. But you can go a little bit deeper and you can reword it into your own words. So what I did, I'd set a little reminder here. I have the orange because that's the orange that I color code for prayer. I have this bubble around it, and this in particular is for me. So I am praying this verse, but I am switching up the words. So I put, bless your servant, O Lord, that I may live and always obey your law. That I always obey your law. That part really, 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 really got me. And then I put, as I write it on my heart. So nowhere in this verse does it say anything about writing it on my heart. But once I wrote out your law, I was like, oh, I like that. How am I going to keep his law? I'm already writing this down. So why not say, as I'm writing out this prayer, I also want to write it down in my heart too. You can take it a step further. You could put it on your heart. You can say, I want to meditate it throughout the day. Just there's a lot of things you guys can be doing with just one simple little verse. All right. So I did also want to share that. And if you're not a fan of marking in your Bible, if you're in my group, you already know better than that. This is what we do. This is what we enjoy. We love to be engaging in the Bible. We like what a Bible looks like when it's all filled up, all marked up, something similar to this. This is what gets us excited about the Bible. This is what gets us where we want to be in the Bible, is this, knowing our devotion that we've put into it, our time, our love. We really know the scripture. Not saying this is proof that I have, I know my scripture better than you because you don't mark in your Bible. This is just how our brains really obtain what we are reading. If we just read it, close up the Bible, okay, we did obtain a little bit, but we're not going to obtain nearly as much as we spend time with every single little verse, all right? And some may not look as this elaborate. This is a Thompson Chain reference Bible. It may be something as simple as that. And there's no right, there is no wrong way. It is only your way on how you can strengthen your relationship with God and how you can grow stronger in a connection with him. That's the only thing that matters. What your Bible looks like, it's only supposed to be for you. Don't ever do something to your Bible for the approval or disapproval of man. All right? So that's always something that you want to do. I was going to tell you what about this. Oh yeah, if you don't want to write it in the Bible, your prayers, and you want to keep them. Let's say you want to keep them in a book, maybe a journal. It doesn't have to be a bound. It can be the Happy Planner disc. It could be a little, traveler's notebook with little inserts. You can use the inserts. You can use a smaller size. You can use a bigger size. Literally, whatever works for you. That's what I want you to do. Don't need to do the same tools that I have. You don't need to use them. You don't need any of that. I did say in the other video, if you do have the extra bit of money and you can make something, get a special notebook just for your love letters, which is what I really like to call them, but your prayers for God, I recommend doing it because your mindset, it goes differently. So if I were to write out my love letters to God in a beautiful looking book, my mindset switches versus just a composition book. That's how it is for me. It may not work for you. You may love your composition notebooks, and it may be different where you are intimidated by a nice looking leather-bound book and you won't even use it, all right? So make sure you do what works best for you, all right? So you can write out, I did it right here. Where am I at? Okay, so the same verses that I did in my Bible that I just showed you, I wrote them out right here. And I am, so if somebody looks at this notebook years from now, they're going to understand what I'm doing. I'm personalizing my prayers through the Psalms. So what I wrote a little bit about it, but right here, the blue or the pink, that's the actual verse, word for word coming out of the Bible. I also have the translation that it is. But in the black color pen below it, That's my own words. I read this, prayed over it, and I put it in my own words. All right. So now I have verses that I can go to whenever I may need them. You can fill out a page for maybe just joy. All these verses that I write here are going to be just for joy. Maybe you can have two or three pages just for that. You can designate certain pages throughout your books for just certain themes, so joy, happiness, or if you're going to go more of the deeper fear, doubt, worry, anxiety, any of those, anger, any of those, I highly recommend having a book like that. Okay, I'm trying to think what else can I do. I'm also writing down this information in particular. I'm getting it from this book. So it's Prayers That Change Things. So it has a lot of information. There's personalizing the Psalms. All right. And then the Prayers Change Things. And this is the power. So why exactly am I doing this? What's the benefit of it? Well, it tells you right here. All right. And again, the more that you do anything, the more that you spend time on anything, the better that you will get at it. When you were first learning to ride the bicycle, remember all the stumbles, all the falls that you did, all the mistakes that you did. Same thing goes with our prayer life. We're not going to be jumping into our prayer life and bam, we know exactly what to do. We feel extremely comfortable in it, confident in it. It takes time. So be patient with yourself. Very, very important. God is very patient and he understands us most of all as his children. You understand when your child comes to you and he doesn't know everything. You don't look down on your child. You don't shame your child. You're understanding because you know he will get there eventually. Same thing that God does with us. All right. So these are some tips, and that's what I am doing right now. As for the Bible, I am simply going to get my Strong's Concordance, go through the list, and I will be highlighting them in my Thompson chain. I thought I was going to do it in my NLT. I love the NLT translation. As you could tell, I have a lot of prayers. This is where I wrote out prayers here. I like this translation, but for the season that I'm in, I don't know. I just want a more meatier a meatier translation, so more wordy, something that's going to make me stop, pause, and think. When it comes to the NLT, NIV, I can just read all the way through, and I don't have to think because there's nothing to think about. It's really simplified to where you understand exactly what you're reading. The KJV, I always say it's for a student that has been in the Bible for a while. I've been in it for nearly 7 years now, so I need to continue to push myself. Even though I may get overwhelmed, I get very easily overwhelmed. You got to push through it. All right, so let's skim through here really quickly. As we know, the orange. Anything that has orange on it is a prayer. So I'm going through each book and I am highlighting that prayer. Any verses that pertain to pray right now, only pray. I haven't made it to the end yet, but on pray. Then I'm going to go back to the very beginning of the book and I'm going to reword them in my book here. All right. The other thing that the Thompson Chain reference has are these amazing helps, and that's in the back. So I don't really need a strong concordance because they have a lot of verses, not as many as a strong concordance, but they have verses that pertain all to pray, or as they say, prayer. So I can also do these. This is prayer. These ones, let's see how far this one goes. I haven't really looked at that. Prayer. See, they don't got it like the Strong's, because the Strong's has praying. They prayed, past tense. This is just prayer, simple prayer. So people that have, I guess, prayer? No, because it says all night. Like he, when it came to those days in the mountain where he prayed and continued in night in prayer to God. Praying, yeah, okay, so they just mixed it right here. So how this is praying, and this is prayer, and this is pray. They just put all this, that theme in one column. So, okay, the Strong's Concordance, it will separate that. So it's, like I said, it's a beneficial tool, but if you don't have it, you don't need to rush out and get it unless you could find it really, really cheap. I wouldn't recommend everyone, every student getting that. All right, so that's everything that I am doing. So I hope to see everyone on this journey with me. It doesn't matter if you're starting today, if you're starting 4 months from now, because this month is really busy, if you start next month. I want to see posts about prayer. Again, if you want to pray over a certain theme, feel free to do so. If you're struggling with anger right now, maybe you're really bumping heads with your significant other and you need help with it. Maybe you're needing help with being judgmental. You like to you're judgmental towards yourself, towards other. Maybe you need help with finding joy in everyday life. Those themes can also be applied to this too, because you can pray over all of those. If I was struggling with fear right now, this is something that I would be doing. I would be going through and marking up all the verses that pertain to fear and praying over them, meditating over them. You can also memorize. That's another thing you guys can do involved with this challenge. Memorize a certain verse, maybe one verse every week. Work on that one verse and memorize it all week. Our challenges are not all going to look the same. Everyone's is different because we are all going through different situations. We are all on a different level when it comes to our Bible study time. And also, we all have different times available to us that we can actually apply. But no matter how much time that we have, please, 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 please put your Bible first. Don't go out, watch a movie, and then say, I'll go ahead and put my Bible time for last. Stop, do the Bible first so you will know it gets done and won't say, just put it off until tomorrow. All right, we all know we've done it. We've all been there. So let's put God first. At least for this 30 days, all right? Get through the 30 days, make it a habit, and you'll find that it starts to get way easier. Okay, that is it. If you do have any questions for me, leave them in the comments below. Again, if you're in the sisters group and you're watching this, remember, be as creative as you want with this. I didn't share anything as being creative, but you totally can. If you're in the markings group, I want you to post how you're marking up your Bible, what you're doing, and include a prayer. You're going to help me help those who cannot have the tools that we have. Don't put the burden only on me, okay? Remember, be a creative tool in our Father's art box. I will talk to you all later. Bye.